1 of our conceptual design competition when the selection panel convened on March 20 of this year to shortlist 5 technically competent firms that would come up with their respective conceptual designs of the Senate building. In no particular order, our 5 shortlisted firms are ICOM, IDEA, Henning Larsen Architects, Leaser, and Pelly Clark Pelly. We also successfully kicked off stage 2 of the competition with the comprehensive briefing of the shortlisted firms on April 4, where members of this chamber were given a chance to share their needs and vision for the new facility. Questions about the conceptual designs had been clearly addressed. The briefing process also included an actual site visit at the Navy Village. Mr. President, as scheduled, all 5 firms have already submitted their conceptual design deliverables at 9 o'clock this morning. And at this very minute, members of my staff are already on course in printing and collating the entries for the technical evaluation. Today, our vision of the new Senate unfolds before us in the form of design sketches and scale models that represent the varying concepts of a green, secure, functional, and iconic building. With your indulgence, may I share with you the submissions of the top 5 firms that we have earlier selected. Kindly dim the lights, please.
Our proposal for the new Senate building of the Philippines is based on 3 primary goals. Number 1, to design a building representing democratic values that is open and accessible to the public, enabling public discourse, debate, dialogue, and exchange of ideas. Number 2, to design a building that is sustainable, representing respect to the environment and Philippine biodiversity, highly functional, while at the same time resilient and an enriching and enjoyable place to be. Number 3, to design a building that symbolizes and embraces the cultural diversity of the Philippines. We are dividing the site into 2 halves, with 1 half being occupied by the executive and administrative buildings which, following the given program, we call buildings A and B, and the other half on the opposite side of the site with the public buildings and other programs, buildings C and D. Buildings A and B contain all areas requiring the highest security control and are therefore clearly separated from the rest of the program. Buildings C and D contain all publicly accessible areas or areas of lower security concern. This configuration allows for maximum security as it separates the public from the private program areas. This configuration also allows for a strong image of the 2 fundamental entities of a democratic system, the elected officials on one side and the general public on the other, with a zone in between for communication and exchange between those entities. Therefore, the program areas that allow or require access by both groups are designed as connecting bridges and, most importantly, symbolizing the dialogue and exchange between the elected officials and the general public. The central and most important of these bridging program elements is the plenary and session hall, allowing the senators and executives as well as the administrative personnel to enter from the highly secured site of building A and B, while the public and press enters from the public building C and D. The symbolic significance is apparent, and this is where the exchange, discourse, debate, and negotiation of politics is visually manifest, accessible, and transparent. Other bridging program areas are the museum, the library, and ceremonial hall. The way the program of the new Senate building is organized, building A being situated above building B and building C above building D, allows for generous sky gardens well above street level to act as a buffer zone and communication spaces for the different programs. The senators in building A will access the elevated sky garden level that the administrators below will have access to as well. From here, one can access the various bridges. The buildings are primarily reinforced concrete structures lined with a louvered, intelligent, automated solar control and shading facade, which at the same time mitigates security threats as it eliminates views into the building itself. The identity and iconic uniqueness of this building is apparent, and its symbolic power as a building representing the complex processes of a democratic, multifaceted society as the Philippines is the goal of this architectural strategy.
Soon, the Senate of the Philippines will move to a new building in Tangking City, Manila. It is a unique opportunity to link the image of the Senate with an iconic building that cares about people's well-being, about the environment, and about Filipino culture. What building form can better achieve that than the form of the Bahá'í Kubo? The Bahá'í Kubo originates from all regions of the nation in various forms and names. They all share ingenious responses to endure the Filipino climate, to use local materials, and Filipinos have gathered beneath their roofs for centuries. We propose to reinvent the Bahá'í Kubo by using modern techniques to celebrate their humanist vision and their common sense. Our design for the Senate takes the form of a group of contemporary Bahá'í Kubos. They symbolize the unity of the nation with an iconic form that every Filipino citizen can relate to. The north of our site will be landscaped to create a beautiful natural setting for the Senate. In contrast, the south of our site should accommodate a lively urban plaza to frame the front of the Senate. Like the Bahá'í Kubo, the Senate buildings are standing on stilts above a shaded and sheltered space. We call it the Silong Plaza. The Silong Plaza orchestrates the entrances, the circulation, and the security of the different populations of the Senate. Their lattice work reflects the rich weaving culture of the Philippines. The hipped roof of the Bahá'í Kubo is a dominant feature in the iconic interiors as well, such as the plenary hall. It is a grand space with a strong Filipino DNA. The ceremonial hall overlooking the skyline of Manila will be an ideal place to represent the Philippines. A building like the Senate is not just a building, it is a symbol of a nation. Let the new Senate building become a vote of confidence in Filipino culture. Let the new Senate building become the national landmark that will usher the Senate to its next 100 years.
Designing something that could possibly be the home of the Senate for the next 100 years. Since this is an institution that represents us as a nation, it should also embody the uniqueness of the Filipino. We ran a survey nationwide to engage the people to co-create the new home of the Senate. We were surprised with the responses we got.
The Senate is supposed to be a chamber imbued with gravitas and a national perspective.
We would like to have a baked-in security in the design.
It should be capable of embracing the people.
Maaliwalas at matiwasay na ano, na building.
Memorable.
Transparency.
Mapagtanggap po.
they want the new home of the Senate to be welcoming, to represent honor and dignity, that will leave a better environment for future generations. The next step for us is to think of a metaphor. What will best represent welcoming, honor and dignity, and sustainability in a form that is uniquely Filipino? If you look at the seal of the Senate, the braids there, the flower, represents Sampaguita, and that represents honor and dignity. The most elegant way of translating Sampaguita to art is through the weave. I have my favorite Barong embroiderer. I realized that they could be my co-creators. So what we did is we invited them from Laguna. They stayed and worked closely with our designers and developed patterns and symbolism that best represent the braided Sampaguita. We mapped that in our basic building mass and projected it in virtual reality. We were able to create both the formal and informal side. The form of the building, which you can see, is a bud of the Sampaguita. Our design has considered a very smart way of facing the project so that we save more than 1.5 billion pesos in capital expense. The mechanical systems that we are introducing considers not only the capital expense side, but also how we will operate the building in the next 100 years, because that has a bigger impact on sustainability. There's a message that we'd like the architecture to convey. Like the braids of the Sampaguita, we have to work as a nation. Each one, the senators, the people, working hand by hand, being bound by one string, and that string is our aspiration for a better country.
To objectively select which among these five conceptual designs, best articulates our vision, a comprehensive scoring system will be adopted for our selection. For the purpose of transparency and for the appreciation of every member of this chamber, let me discuss our scoring methodology at length. Our scoring system has three components: the technical score comprising 40% of the overall score, the people's choice at 5%, and the executive ranking at 55%. The technical score will be determined by the Technical Evaluation Committee comprising representatives from the Senate and the BCDA and pre-selected experts from relevant professional disciplines such as architecture, engineering, interior design, and cultural research, among others. These experts are from different government agencies, reputable professional organizations, and the academe, namely the Philippine Institute of Interior Designers, Philippine Institute of Environmental Planners, National Committee on Architecture and Allied Arts, Department of Public Works and Highways, United Architects of the Philippines, Philippine Association of Landscape Architects, UST College of Architecture, and the Bonifacio Estate Services Corporation. This committee will review and evaluate the design entries based on four criteria: sustainability, functionality, and feasibility. Each comprises 20% of the overall technical score, and identity, which makes up the biggest percentage score of 40%. The Technical Evaluation Committee will objectively rate the entries per criterion independent of the other and provide technical comments for each design entry. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, the Technical Evaluation Committee will officially convene tomorrow, May 22, to start the technical review. The second component of our scoring system is the people's choice. The people's choice, which I consider as the swing vote, will allow the Senate community, meaning our staff and our employees, to take part in the decision process. All Senate staff are encouraged to select one entry design on May 23, 2018. The voting process shall be administered by the Office of the Deputy Secretary for Administration and Finance. Finally, the executive ranking, which comprises the highest percentage score of 55%, will be determined by each of us, senators of this republic. BCDA Chairman Gregorio Garcia and BCDA President Vivencio Hison, during the final presentations of the designs set on May 28, 2018. Aside from the presentation per firm, we will also be provided with a summary of the scores and technical comments by the Technical Evaluation Committee and the result of the people's choice. The ranking system will be simple. Each of the executives, meaning us, will categorically rank the designs from 1 to 5, 1 being our top choice and 5 being the least, based on our overall impression and consideration of each design as a sum of its parts. Mr. President, to ensure the integrity and fairness of the scoring system, I wish to put emphasis on the established competition mechanics that only executives who are present for the entire duration of the final presentations are allowed to cast their votes or scores. The final presentations of the designs on May 28, 2018 will promptly start at 9 o'clock in the morning at the Recto Laurel Pexon Committee Rooms. Thus, I am earnestly requesting everyone to be on time so as not to forfeit your right to vote. In sum, this comprehensive scoring system puts primacy to the important technical aspects of the design and also ensures that the preferences of the different stakeholders of the facility are taken into account. Mr. President, may I reiterate, I urge everyone to cast their votes and take part in this milestone initiative of building a home we envision for the Senate. Thank you, Mr. President.
The Majority Leader.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President,
by the
1 minute suspension.
Before the suspension, we would like to commend Senator Lacson, the Chairman of the Committee on Accounts, for the presentation. It will make our choice easier after this presentation. So thank you, Senator Lacson. The Majority Leader, again.
Yes, Mr. President, that he made a report to the body, not necessary to refer his report to any committee. We'd like to congratulate the good senator for all the hard work is put in to find a new home for the Senate, Mr. President. That's been a dream of ours even in the 14th Congress and in many Congresses before us. Mr. President, before we move for consideration of the reference of business, Senator Chis Escudero, Chairman of the Senate panel of the Joint Congressional Oversight Committee, would like to nominate Senator Coco Pimentel as the new chair of the Senate panel Joint Congressional Oversight Committee and Senator Chis to be the vice chairman, Mr. President.